وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى، وإن ذا كتاب نواقض الإسلام، The Nullifiers of Islam, written by شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله. The Sheikh, we reached الناقض الرابع, the fourth nullifier. We reached the fourth nullifier. What we did last lesson was not on camera. So now we're going to do it inshallah ta'ala. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah, he said, "Man i'taqada," anybody who believes. Can I see your copy? Mm-hmm. Anyone have another copy? Oh, you're Sheikh Salah Fuzan as well. Anyone have it? Yeah, kind of. Yeah, let me look at this one. Okay, can I have your matal? The small one. Yeah, I'm going to use your one. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, "Man i'taqada," anybody who believes, "anna ghayra hadi an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallama," anybody who believes that other than the Prophet's guidance, is akmalu min hadihi, more complete than the Prophet's guidance. So he believes there's a guidance greater than the Prophet's guidance, a way that's better than the Prophet's way, alayhi salatu wasalam. That's what the Shaykh said. Oh, or anna hukma ghayrihi, or the laws. Oh, anna hukma ghayrihi ahsanu min hukmihi, is greater than his rulings. He believes there's rules, regulations, laws that are better than the Prophet's laws, alayhi salatu wasalam. كَالَّذِينَ, like the ones, يُفَضِّلُونَ, who give superiority, they glorify. What do they glorify? حُكْمَ الطَّوَاغِيتِ, man-made constitutions. We'll speak about what طَاغُوت means in details today, inshaAllah ta'ala. عَلَى حُكْمِهِ, over the Prophet's laws. The Shaykh says, فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ, this person is a disbeliever. This person is what? Is a disbeliever. I'lam, know my beloved brothers and sisters. Allamani Allah wa iyyakum, may Allah educate all of us and allow us to learn. A statement that I'm going to read from to you all, that Al-Imam al-Shafi'i said in his kitab Mukhtalaf al-Hadith. This is the muqaddima of the kitab Mukhtalaf al-Hadith by Al-Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to clarify for the people that which he obliged on them. Allah brought the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah made him a messenger and a prophet. He brought us and sent the Prophet to us so that the Prophet will clarify for us that which Allah made obligatory upon us. And also, Ibn Muhammad, Al-Imam al-Shafi'i said, sorry, Al-Imam Shafi'i also said, ثُمَّ عَلَى لِسَانِ نَبِيِّهِ, and also on the tongue of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah also made some things obligatory which you may not find in the Quran. Just like He is one to clarify that which Allah has made obligatory upon the people. The Prophet clarified it. Are we all together? That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he clarified to the people that which was made obligatory on them. That was his job, alayhi salatu wasalam. But what did he also do? He came with rules and regulations that you will not find in the Quran. Al-Imam Shafi'i went on to say, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guided the people to the straight path. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala commanded in the Quran for the people to obey him and made it obligatory on them. And he commanded them to take what he has come with and to stay away from that which he stayed away from, alayhi salatu wasalam. The obligation of following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is upon every single person who saw him and anyone who would come after him until the day of judgment. That statement is from none other than Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah. Shafi'i benefited us something. That the following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam doesn't only have to be that which he said that's in line with the Quran. He also, alayhi salatu wasalam, comes with rules that we need to follow. Because why? He is somebody who has to be obeyed, just like Allah needs to be obeyed. Just like Allah needs to be obeyed, the Prophet needs to be obeyed. ولذلك, brothers, if you think about it, when it came to the companion statement, when they said, لو شاء الله, if Allah willed, وشاء محمد, and Muhammad willed, did the Prophet become happy with that, or was he upset when they said that statement? When they said, if Allah wills, and then the Prophet wills, the Prophet ﷺ became upset with them. He said to them, قُلْ سَيْءٍ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ if Allah wills. I mean, what Allah wills. And in some riwayat he said, ثُمَّ after that, مَا شَاءَ مُحَمَّدٍ. So he corrected the wow in which they were using. And the wow shows what? That you're making equal Allah's mashi'ah to the what? The mashi'ah of the Prophet. I mean, the want of Allah and the will of Allah and the will of the Messenger, you're making it equal, right? But if you look at the Quran, when it came to obedience, Allah used that well. Look what He says, وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ obey Allah. In the ayah, Allah says, قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ obey Allah. And then Allah says, وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ and obey the Messenger. Why? The obedience of Allah and the Messenger are the same. Because the Prophet's obedience is obeying Allah Himself. So you have to obey Allah. You have to obey the Prophet at the same. Everything which He came with is what Allah told him to come with. So by obeying him in everything, it means you're obeying who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ that wow is used. That the obedience is the same. Allah connects him, the Prophet, to what? To himself all the time. And this is to show you that anybody who doesn't obey Allah, doesn't obey the Messenger, has not obeyed Allah. However much he claims that he's obeying Allah, if he doesn't obey the Messenger, he doesn't obey Allah. ولذلك the ulama, قرنًا بعد قرن, generation after generation, centuries after centuries, decades after decades, years after years, have agreed upon anybody who turns away from the Prophet's laws, turns away from the Prophet's legislations, turns away from it, and doesn't take it into consideration, and says, مثلاً, I'm a Qur'ani, I only follow the Qur'an, that they are kuffarun, that they are what? Kuffar, disbelievers, and they are not in any relationship with Islam. They have nothing to do with Islam. Look what Shaykh al-Islam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyah said in his great kitab, Tahdhib al-Sunan. He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Nabiullah Muhammad rahmatan lil alameen. Allah sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a what? A rahmah. Rahmah means what? Mercy. To what? To the universe. Allah sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a what? A mercy to the universe. Alayhi salatu wa sallam. Rahmatan lil alameen. And he also sent him a what? A beacon of light for those who want to tread on Allah's path. If they want to go to Allah, the Prophet has shined that road for them. He has made light for them in which they can know to go to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He also made the Prophet what? وَحُجَّةً عَلَى جَمِيعِ الْمُكَلَّفِينَ. proof on every individual who's reached puberty and is sane. Every person who's reached age of puberty and is sane, Allah made the Prophet a proof against them or a proof for them. فَرَّقَ اللَّهُ بِهِ بِرِسَالَتِهِ Allah distinguished, based on the Prophet's message, Allah distinguished between what? Al-huda wal-dalal, guidance and misguidance. If you want to know what guidance is, it's what's in accordance to him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Do you want to know what misguidance is? It's anything that's in opposition to him. Through him, the true guidance and misguidance is distinguished, alayhi salatu wasalam. Wal-ghayyi wal-rashad. And what is deviation and what is uprightness? All of it is based upon the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam. Wal-shakki wal-yaqeen. Certainty and doubt is all based upon the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam. If you're in line with him, then you're upon certainty. And if you're away from his path, then that is doubt in which you have treaded on. فَوَ الْمِيزَانُ الرَّاجِحُ If you want to fairly scale somebody, you base them upon how much they are following the Prophet ﷺ. You base every person in line with the Prophet's speech, وَأَعْمَالِ the Prophet's actions, وَأَخْلَاقِ the Prophet's etiquette, تُوزَنُ الْأَخْلَاقِ وَالْأَعْمَالِ وَالْأَقْوَالِ وَالْأَفْعَالِ Every etiquette a person comes with, we base it upon if it's in line with the Prophet, then it's a good etiquette. Not that we scale everything on our culture and our way of seeing things. We do it in accordance to the Prophet's etiquette and the Prophet's action and the Prophet's speech. If we want to see if a person's statement is right, if the Prophet said it, then it's right. If we want to see if a person's action is correct, we see if the Prophet did this action. Everything, we scale it on the Prophet ﷺ. If it's in line with that, then it's correct. وَبِمُتَابَعَةِ وَالِاقْتِدَاءِ بِهِ And by following him and taking him as a role model, it distinguishes us, it distinguishes for us. It allows us to know the difference between Ahlul Huda min Ahlul Dalal, the people of guidance from the people of misguidance. Following the Prophet, taking him as a role model, is what we will know who is upon guidance, who is upon the path that pleases Allah, who is away from the path of Jahima, the hellfire, and the person who is on the path of misguidance and corruption and torment. We will know based upon the Prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala hini fatrati min al-rusul. Allah sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at a duration after messengers and prophets came. And Allah through him alayhi wa sallam fahadda bihi ila aqwamit turuq wa awdahis subul. Through the Prophet, Allah guided those who followed him to the best of paths, to the clearest of paths. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He obliged upon every single body ta'atu obeying the Prophet, wa mahabbatuhu loving him, wa ta'ziruhu venerating and glorifying him, wa tawqirihi and honoring him, wal qiyamu and standing up bihuquqihi, his rights, alayhi salatu wasalam. To stand up for what? His rights. Allah made it obligatory on every one of us. Those statements are from who? Al-Allama ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala. He went on to say, sorry, وَأَغْلَقَ دُونَ جَنَّةِ الْأَبْوَابِ And Allah closed off every door to his Jannah and every path to him, Allah blocked it. And the only path he let open is the path in which the Prophet was upon and his companions. That's the only path that will lead to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every other path, Allah blocked it. لذلك, what did he say? The great Imam, he said, الطرق كلها مسدودة. Every path is blocked, it's closed, it's barricaded. There's no way to it. إلا طريق من اقتفى أثر محمد. Except the person who follows the path of what? نبي الله محمد. طرق كلها مسدودة. There's no way to Allah. You want to get to Allah? All the roads are closed. There's only one road to go towards him. What is that road? طريق من اقتفى أثر محمد. The path of the person who follows the Prophet ﷺ. Allah tells us, in many places in the Quran, to obey him, to follow him, to adhere to his way, alayhi salatu salam. Allah said to them, قُلْ say to them, Muhammad, أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ obey Allah, وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ and obey the messenger. فَإِن تَوَلُّوا If they turn away from what? Pay attention to this. If they turn away from what? From the two that just were mentioned, Allah, obeying Allah and obeying the messenger. If you turn away from that, فَإِن تَوَلُّوا If the people turn away فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْهِمَا حُمِّلَ وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ. Then upon them is what they have carried, and upon you is what you carried, Muhammad. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ, if you obey him, تَهْتَدُوا, you'll be guided. Ha, this is guidance. If you want another person's guided, they follow the Prophet. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ, if you follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, تَهْتَدُوا, you'll be guided. وَمَا عَلَى الرَّسُولِ, there's nothing upon the Prophet except what? إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينُ. Upon him is the what? It is the clear conveying. That's all that's upon him, alayhi salatu wasalam. He just needs to convey the message. Whether the people accept it or whether they take it in, that's not his job. Upon him is what? That he conveys the message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal nabi, O Messenger of Allah, Inna arsalnaka, we have sent you. What? Shahidan, a testimony against the people. A proof and a witness over them. Wa mubashiran, you're one who comes with glad tidings. Wa nadhiran, you're one who warns. This is his da'wah. He's shahidan, wa mubashiran, wa nadhira. People today, what they say to you? Why are you overlooking me? Why are you observing my situation? Why are you policing me? Shahidan. You're looking over them, Muhammad. You're looking at their actions and what they're doing. If it's in line with what Allah is pleased with, or whether it's against, that's the job of a person who's calling to Allah's path. Shahidan. وَمُبَشِّرًا, you're giving the people glad tidings. وَنَذِيرًا, you're warning the people. And then a person who is da'wah, it has to be in line with the da'wah of the Prophet. He can't just give good glad tidings all day. He doesn't just give good news all the time. He warns. He warns. Just like the Prophet warned, alayhi salatu wasalam. وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ, you're a caller to Allah, بِإِذْنِهِ, with his permission. وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا, and you're a lamp that guides the people, see the path to Allah. وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and give the glad tidings to the believers. بِأَنَّ لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ, that they will gain from their Lord Allah تبارك وتعالى. فَضْلًا, a great virtue. كَبِيرًا. Allah also says, قُلْ, say to them, Muhammad, إِن كُنْتُمْ, if you love, تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ, if you love Allah, if you truly are sincere and you really mean the statement that you love Allah, if you do really love Allah, فَاتَّبِعُونِ, follow me as the messenger. If you really love Allah, and this claim of yours, of loving Allah, is genuine and it's real, you really mean that, then how do we know that you're saying the truth? How do we know that it's genuine? We're going to test it. How are we going to test it? فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحِبُّبُكُمُ اللَّهِ. The Prophet said, follow me. If you really love Allah, then follow me. So anybody who says, I love Allah, I love him so much, but he's not following the Prophet, then this love is what? It's a lie. It's not true. It's not true. Why? Hassan al-Basri, he said that this ayah is ayah al-imtihan wal-ibtila, the ayah of imtihan, the verse of testing. It's to test people's love. Sahih? So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He allowed us to know who loves Allah and who really doesn't love Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. How do we know that one who loves Allah? We'll just base it upon how much they follow the Prophet. Sah? Some people just think following the Prophet means that you follow him in the way you dress only. Some people, that's what they think. And is your garment above your ankles? And is your beard long? That's all they think and they've understood from following the Prophet. Sah? You're following qalban wa qaliban. You're following internally in your heart. And you're following him what? Externally in all of your situations. As much as you follow him in the way you dress and the way you look, you follow him the way he was when he was happy. You follow him in that. You follow him in the time when he was angry, alayhi salatu, the way he would act is the way you try to act, alayhi salatu. When he spoke, the way he carried himself, in every situation, you observe that and follow him in that. That's a sign of loving who? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحِبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Ibn Kathir said, ادَّعَى, he got this from Hassan al-Basri. Hassan al-Basri said, ادَّعَى قَوْمٌ مَحَبَّةَ اللَّهِ. A group of people, they came out and they claimed that they love Allah. فَبْتَلَاهُمُ اللَّهُ بِهَذِي الْآيَةِ. Allah tested them with this verse. Hassan al-Basri said that. ادَّعَى, a group of people came out and what they said is, we love Allah. They shouted it on the top of their lungs. When they said that, Allah sent the verse down to test their love. Okay. Do you really love Allah? Okay. What does that tell you, brothers and sisters? That this claim that something is only in my heart, it's in my heart, this ayah, it nullifies it from the roots. Which is that, if this is in your heart, then let it manifest on your limbs. Let it be seen on you. The sister that says, I love Allah, and she's not dressing like Khadija, and she's not like Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and she's not like Ummul Mu'mineen, the believer, the mothers of the believers, and she doesn't look like them, then her love of Allah is what? It's a false love. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in this verse, He commanded her to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you follow the Prophet, what happens? فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي follow me, يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ Allah will love you, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ And Allah will what? Will forgive you for your sins. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is what? He's what? غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said in the Quran, مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ Anyone who obeys the what? The messenger. فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ Anyone who obeys the messenger has obeyed who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anybody, Allah is saying this in the Quran, مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ Anyone who obeys the messenger has obeyed Allah. Because Allah told you to follow the Prophet. ولذلك you know the famous hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, in which he said that لَعَنَ اللَّهُ الْوَاشِمَ Allah cursed the woman that does tattooing and the one who does the tattooing for her and the woman who plucks her eyebrows and the one who does it for her, Allah cursed them. So then a woman said, Ya ibn Mas'ud, Allah cursed them? He said, it's in the Quran. She said, Ya ibn Mas'ud, Abu Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, I read the Quran. It's a woman who knew the Quran. She knew the whole Quran. She said, I read it from one cover to another cover. I read the book of Allah. And that statement of yours is nowhere to be found in the Quran. And he said to her, have you read it? She said, yes. She said, what? He said, yes, I read it. He said to her, did you read the Quran? She said, yes, I read the Quran. He said, didn't Allah say in the Quran, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنُوا فَانْتَهُ Whatever the Prophet comes and gives you, take it from him. And whatever he prohibits you from, stay away from. Some people's translation of the ayah, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ What do they say? أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ means what? They say anything that the Prophet does, follow him in it. وَهَذَا خَطَأ That's what the ayah said. Because the ayah says, وَمَا أَتَاكُمْ If you can't tell the difference between وَمَا أَتَاكُمْ لَأَتَاكُمْ If you can't tell the difference, then don't comment on the Qur'an. There's a farq in the Arabic language between أَتَاكُمْ and أَتَاكُمْ One is فِعْلْ لَازِمْ, one is فِعْلْ مُتَعَدِّي أَتَاكُمْ means what? Whatever the Prophet brings to you, take it from him. Whatever he brings to you, take it from him. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ Whatever he prohibits you from, stay away from it. He read this ayah, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and then the woman said, He said, and then the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Prophet said what? That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ الْوَاشِمَةُ وَالْوَاشِمَةُ And he made the hadith. So this was what the Sahabas would understand. Now what the Prophet said is like what Allah said. They wouldn't distinguish between the two. So the woman, she became upset in the sense where she got the matter wrong and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud got it right. So she stood up and she went to Ibn Mas'ud's house. She went to Ibn Mas'ud's house and she said, some of your women actually, she didn't go to his house first, she said to him, some of your women actually do this. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said to her, come. He took him to his house. He said, look at the women in my house. Find any woman who has any of these characteristics and I promise you, she will not stay a day in this house with me. They checked, none of them had tattoos, none of them had plucked their eyebrows. That's how the Sahabas were. They wouldn't stay with a person whose la'an of Allah is coming down on them. A woman who Allah's la'an is cursed. You guys remember the hadith of the camel, the man who was riding the camel, and then the camel disobeyed the owner, and then the man cursed the camel. And then the man wanted that, after cursing the camel, the man wanted to carry on riding the camel. And the Prophet said, no, let this camel free. You're not going to let something you've cursed, and Allah's curse is coming down on it, stay with us. Let this camel free. You cursed it, right? If you've cursed this camel, then the curse of Allah is coming down on it. And it's with us. And the curse of Allah is coming down. Let this camel free, the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam. So a woman who's like this, whose curse of Allah is coming to you, either let her go free, say, look, you're free to go, inshallah ta'ala, or let her change her ways. Let her change her ways. ولذلك الله تبارك وتعالى سيدنا القرآن فليحذر الذين يخالفون عن أمره أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. فليحذر الذين, be cautious of those who are opposing. فليحذر الذين, let those who are opposing, يخالفون عن أمره, who are opposing the affairs of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and are going against him, let them be cautious and be concerned and worried about what? أن تصيبهم فتنة, that they are going to be thrown into calamity, أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. Abdul Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, fitna here means ridda, apostasy. Fitna here means an tusibahum fitna. Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, fitna here means what? Ar-ridda, apostasy. The person, the sister would one day refuse to take this ruling, and then the next day she was refusing. Or the brother, he'll just say, no, I want to cut my beard. And it won't just stay there. It will finally become apostasy. You finally say, you know what, I don't know about this religious, barbaric, man. It's nothing to do with me. And it will just apostate. And then one refusal of following the Prophet will finally, or a position of the Prophet will finally lead to apostasy. That's where it's going to come to, apostasy. That's what the ayah says. فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً. Fitna here means a ridda, Ahmed said. أو يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ, or a severe punishment awaits them the day of judgment. The way, inshallah ta'ala, we plan to speak about this nullifier, and the way we explain it, we'll explain it, is in two points, inshallah ta'ala. The first point is that given superiority, this is the first point, inshallah ta'ala. The first point is taqdeemu hadi ghayri nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Given superiority to what? To other than the Prophet's guidance, over the Prophet's guidance, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah, he brought three ways it happens in this book. Three nullifiers that he mentioned. Muhammad mentioned three nullifiers of it. Are you with me? Giving superiority, taqdeem, huh? Giving precedence to what? A guidance over the guidance of the Prophet. Okay? It comes in three ways according to Muhammad. It's more than that, but Muhammad only mentioned three of them which nullify the person really. The first one of it being that believing that there is a guidance greater and more complete than the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's the one we're on right now. It's the fourth one. The second one that he's going to bring is al-i'radu an shari'ati. The person is turning away. Okay, and we'll discuss what that means. Al-i'rad, the person turns away from the sharia of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He doesn't judge by it and he doesn't go towards it as a judgment. لا يحكمه, he doesn't judge on it, ولا يتحاكم إليها, and he doesn't come to it as a judgment. The third that Muhammad Abdab also mentions is أن يعتقد, he believes أنه يسعه الخروج عن شريعة الرسول. He believes that it's permissible for him to go out of the law of Allah. Okay, and we're going to come to that as well, inshallah ta'ala. And then the last two, they're going to come to us, بإذن الله الكريم. The author, he made it each a nullifier. And we'll discuss it there, بإذن الله الكريم. But what concerns us here is the first one of them, which is the statement that he said, اعتقاد, to believe, أن هدي, to believe that أن غير هدي النبي, that other than the Prophet's guidance, أكمل من هدي, is more complete than the Prophet's guidance. The way we plan to go through that is in different ways. Point number one. معنى الهدي. What does guidance actually mean? What does هدي actually mean? هدي means الطريق. It means a path. It means a sunnah. It means a way. التي كان عليها, in which he was. التي كان عليها النبي, that the Prophet was upon. It is a path. It is a way. التي كان عليها النبي, that the Prophet was upon. فمن اعتقد, anybody who believes. Okay, so hadi here means al-tariq wa sunnah. It means the path, it means the road, in which the Prophet was upon. فَمَنِ اعْتَقَدَ, anybody who believes, أن هديه أحسن وأكمل, he believes that his way and his path is more greater and more better than the Prophet's way of life and the way that the Prophet set it for us, فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ, that this person is a disbeliever. kufran akbar, he leaves the fold of Islam. It's not minor, it's major. Major. Point number two. Why is this nullifier a kufr? What's the reason? We mentioned it last lesson, which is that this is what? The reason why it's kufr is because it's what? It falls under, the asal it falls under is what? Mukaddiban lillahi wa li rasuli. He's a disbeliever of Allah and the Messenger. He disbelieves in Allah and the Messenger. Because what he did is rejected the guidance of Allah and the Messenger. And he has placed a guidance other than it. Ma'a ikhbarillah. Even that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already told us that the guidance of the Prophet and that Allah's guidance is greater than any individual's guidance, right? Point number three. What's the evidence for this? What is the evidence for this? The evidence for this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his statements, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى, that the Prophet does not speak from what? Whims and desires. The Prophet, when he speaks, he doesn't speak from whims. This is all what? إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. It's all revelation from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Al-Allama Muhammad al-Amini Shanqiti, he says in Adwa'ul Bayan, إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. He says, ma'anahu, it means, أَنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لَا يُبَلِّغُ عَنِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا شَيْئًا أَوْحَاهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ أَنْ يُبَلِّغَهُ. That the Prophet does not convey from Allah anything except it was a revelation from Allah that was told to him to convey it to the people. فَمَنْ يَقُولُ, anyone who says, إِنَّهُ شِعْرٌ, that this is poetry, وَسِحْرٌ, this is magic, this is kahana, it's fortune telling, أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ, it is the stories of the previous people, فَوَأَكْذَبُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ, he is the what? The greatest liar of the from the creations of Allah, وَأَكْفَرُهُمْ, and he's the greatest disbeliever. Al-Imam al-Iraqi in his kitab, طَرْحُ التَّثْرِيب, he says, وَوَصَفَ السُّنَّةِ بِالْإِنْزَالِ, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he described the sunnah as to be what? A revelation. فَقَدْ كَانَ الْوَحْيُ يَنْزِلُ, the revelation would come down, كَمَا يَنْزِلُ الْقُرْآنِ, just like the Qur'an would come down. I mean, the sunnah would come down just like the Qur'an comes down. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, what did he say? As-sunnah wahyun yutla. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i said that the sunnah is a revelation that's recited. It's a revelation that's recited, he said. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, وَمَعْلُومٌ بِالِضِّرَارِ, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, it's known out of necessity min din al-Islam, from the religion of Islam, وَبِتِفَاقِ جَمِيعِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and by consensus of all of the Muslims, أَنَّ مَنْ سَوَّغَ يَعْنِ أَبَاحَ, anybody who permits, who makes it lawful, he makes it lawful, اتِّبَاعَ, the following, غَيْرَ هَدِي الْإِسْلَامِ, he makes it lawful in following other than the guidance of Islam. He permits this. In following اتِّبَاعَ غَيْرَ دِينِ الْإِسْلَامِ, he says it is permissible to follow other than Islam. It's permissible. It's allowed. أو اتِّبَاعَ الشَّرِيعَةِ, or it's allowed to follow a legislation غَيْرَ شَرِيعَةِ مُحَمَّدٍ, other than the Sharia of the Prophet ﷺ. فَوَ كَافِرٌ, it's a disbeliever. He's a what? He's a disbeliever. That's the first evidence that we've brought. Okay? The second evidence is what? فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ, if you dispute one another in a matter, فَرُدُّوهُ, bring it back to what? إِلَى اللَّهِ, bring it back to Allah. وَالرَّسُولِ, and bring it back to the Messenger. إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, if you believe in Allah and the Day of Judgment. Al-Allama ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah in his kitab Al-Risalat al-Tabukiyya, Al-Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah in his Risalah al-Tabukiyya, he mentions from page 133 to 134, he says, with the tahqiq of the kitab, the tahqiq of that book is Salim Hilali. Ibn al-Qayyim says, وَهَذَا دَلِيلٌ قَاطِعٌ, this is a clear-cut evidence, عَلَى أَنَّهُ يَجِبُ, that is obligatory, رَدُّ مَوَارِدُ النِّزَاعِ, the point of disputations and arguments, that they have to be brought back, فِي كُلِّ مَا تَنَازَ, everything we dispute in, or the people dispute in from the religion, all of it has to be brought back to إِلَى اللَّهِ, to Allah, وَرَسُولِهِ, and His Messenger. If we have an argument, if we have a dispute, we differ upon a particular issue, Who do we bring it back to? We bring it back to Allah and His Messenger. لا إلى أحد غير الله ورسوله. Not to anybody other than Allah and His Messenger. You don't bring it back to a holy scholar or sheikh or this. You bring the matter back to Allah and His Messenger. فمن أحال الرد. Look what Shaykh al-Islam Ibn al-Qayyim says. Anybody who diverts that and turns it towards what? إلى غيرهما other than Allah and His Messenger. فقد ضاد أمر الله. This person has opposed the command of Allah. ومن دعا أمر الله. ومن دعا عند النزاع. And anybody who calls to at times of disputes and argumentation إلى تحكيم غير الله, enrolling in other than Allah's law and the law of the Messenger, فقد دعا بدعوة الجاهلية. Then this person has called out to the calling of جاهلية. فلا يدخل العبد في الإيمان. A person will not enter into Iman حتى يرد كل ما تنازع فيه المتنازعون إلى الله ورسوله. A person will not enter into Islam until every disputes and arguments that the people dispute and argue to, he brings it back to Allah and His Messenger. ولهذا قال الله تعالى, because of that Allah says, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ, if you dispute each other in a matter, في شَيْءٍ, in anything, anything we dispute each other, فَرُدُّهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ, bring it back to Allah and His Messenger. إِن كُنْتُمْ, if you are believers, إِن, look at this, if you are believers of Allah and His Messenger, and the Day of Judgment. Look what Ibn al-Qayyim goes on to say, وَهَذَا مِمَّا ذَكَرْنَاهُ, this which we have mentioned, آنِفًا, شَرْطٌ, it's a condition. إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ, the in here is شَرْطِيَة. The in here is a what? It's a conditional. آنِفًا, شَرْطٌ يَنْتَفِي الْمَشْرُوطُ بِانْتِفَائِهِ. And if the thing that was mentioned before that, which is bringing it back to Allah and His Messenger at times of disputation and argumentation, is the condition of this Iman. So if the shart is connected to the mashrut, okay, yantafil mashrut, the mashrut will go if this condition is not met. So you're not a believer. فدل, then indicated, على أن من حكم غير الله, the person who rules other than Allah تبارك وتعالى and His Messenger, في موارد, in the times of مقتضى النزاع, when there's arguments going on, people are differing, كان خارجا من مقتضى الإيمان بالله واليوم الآخر. Then this person is what? He's left the what? This person has left the belief of Allah and the Day of Judgment. What you need to ponder here and really understand is what? This is not talking about on the leader scale, it's talking to even the general mass. Our khilafat and the niza'at that we have, the disputes that we have fima baynana, between ourselves, it has to be brought back to Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn al-Qayyim went on to say in that place, he said, وَقَدْ اتَّفَقَ السَّلَفُ وَالْخَلَفُ, he said that the Salaf, pious predecessors, وَالْخَلَفُ, and the noble scholars after that, the late generation, all of them have agreed, عَلَى أَنَّ الرَّدَّ إِلَى اللَّهِ, bring it back to Allah, is هُوَ الرَّدُّ إِلَى كِتَابِ, bring it back to His Kitab. وَالرَّدُّ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ, and bringing it back to the Messenger, هُوَ الرَّدُّ إِلَى فِي حَيَاتِ, it is to bring it back to him whilst he was alive. When he was alive, you bring it back to him. وَالرَّدُّ إِلَى سُنَّتِهِ بَعْدَ وَفَاتِهِ, and after he died, you bring it back to his what? You bring it back to his sunnah, alayhi salatu wasalam. There are many evidences. Allah also says in another ayah, وَيَقُولُونَ, they will say, آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ, we believe in Allah. That's what they will say to you. وَبِالرَّسُولِ, we believe in the Messenger. وَأَطَعْنَا, we obeyed. ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ, and then a group of them will turn away. They will say to you, I believe in Allah, I believe in the Messenger, we obey them both. But then look, ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ, a group of them will turn away. مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ, after the statement of theirs, Allah then says, وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ, these are not believers. وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, if they are called to Allah, وَرَسُولِهِ, and His Messenger, لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ, for Allah and His Messenger to be the one that their rule is going to be in his hands, Allah is going to deal with it, what do they do? بَيْنَهُمْ إِلَى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ, a group of them come with إعراض. They come with what? They come with إعراض. And we'll speak about what إعراض means in details, inshaAllah ta'ala. Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, says in the tafsir of this ayah, he says, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, Allah is informing us of the characteristics of the munafiqeen, those which show opposite to what they hide. And they say a statement with their tongue, which is what? They say it with their tongue. This is a statement on their tongue, which is, وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ, we believe in Allah, وَبِالرَّسُولِ, we believe in the Messenger, وَأَطَعْنَا, and we obey them, ثم يتولى فريق منهم من بعد ذلك. All of this is what they say on their tongue. We believe in Allah, we believe in the messenger, we obey them both, they mean a lot to us. They say this on their tongue. But after that, أَن يُخَالِفُونَ أَقْوَالَهُمْ بِأَعْمَالِهِمْ. The statement of theirs is in opposition to their actions. فَيَقُولُونَ مَا لَا يَفْعَلُونَ. They do what they are, they say what they're not doing. ولهذا Allah said about them, he said ابن كثير, وَمَا أُولَئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That these people are not believers. وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. If they are called to Allah and His Messenger, لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ, to be judged between it. Ibn Kathir says, A, it means, if it's requested from them to follow the guidance that has been sent to us from Allah, on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ, they turn away from it. وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا, they become arrogant, فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ, in themselves, in following it. Something like that, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said in his kitab, صارم المصلول على شاتم الرسول. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said something like that as well. So today it's sad that you see a Muslim today being told, Allah said this, the messenger said this. It's not a light matter that you turn away. You turn away. Or you say, my Shaykh said. If this issue is a discussion and it's a debate and it's a khilafi issue, then bring it back to the kitab and the sunnah. Allah says in another ayah, وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَحُكْمُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. You do not dispute each other in a matter except the rules is going to be found with Allah. وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ. You do not differ فِي مَا بَيْنَكُمْ, between yourselves, in an issue. وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَحُكْمُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. The rule is going to be ready with Allah تبارك وتعالى. Allah is going to have an answer for you. Point number four. الإجماع. There's a consensus on this issue. There's a what? There's a consensus. Remember I said this nullifier we're going to speak about in two angles, right? We're still on the first point, right? Under the first point, we brought 4 points under it. Sah? Are we all together? These are the 4 points that we brought under the first. We haven't come to the second part that we're going to discuss, inshallah ta'ala. There's a consensus in this issue. That anybody who believes that there's a guidance other than the Prophet's guidance, which is greater, then the Prophet's guidance, there's a consensus that he's a kafir. Allamah ibn al-Qayyim, Allamah ibn al-Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, he brought the consensus. He said, أَجْمَعَ الْعُلَمَاء. The scholars are unanimously agreed upon. عَلَى أَنَّ مَنْ زَعَمَ. Anybody who claims, أَنَّ حُكْمَ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ. Anybody who believes that other than the law of Allah is greater than Allah's rules, or أَنَّ هَدِّ, or he believes a guidance is better than the Prophet's guidance, فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ ضَالٌ, he's a disbeliever, misguided. Very good. Point number five. Some statements of نقولات العلماء, some statements of the scholars regarding this nullifier. If you look at the 10th volume, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah's Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 10th volume, page 267. Instead of reading it, you can look at it yourself. Second naqal, the second statement, is as Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah himself. The 28th volume, page 471, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah. Go to Sharh Aqidat al-Tahawiyyah. Sharh Aqidat al-Tahawiyyah. With the tahqiq of who? Shaykh al-Albani. So go get the copy, which is Maktabat al-Islami. With the tahqiq of Shaykh al-Albani on it. Go to the Sharh of Al-Izz ibn Abd Salam, Sharh Aqid Tahawiyyah, Al-Izz ibn Abd Salam. Get the tahqiq of Shaykh Al-Bani, rahimahullah. Page 200. Read the kalam of Al-Izz ibn Abd Salam, rahimahullah ta'ala. Not Al-Izz ibn Abd Salam, I don't know why I said that. Ibn Abil Izz al-Hanafi, sorry. The sharh is written by who? Ibn Abil Izz al-Hanafi, sorry. Ibn Abi al-Izz al-Hanafi, Sharah al-Aqidah al-Tahawiyyah, with the tahqiq of who? Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala. If you want, also go to the kalam of Imam al-Shawkani in the ayah that I just recited before, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. I didn't recite that ayah. But that ayah, look at Shawkani what he said in his tafsir, Fathul Qadir. The first volume, page 484. You find it. Look at Muhammad Amin al-Shanqiti on the tafsir of that ayah as well. The first volume, page 334. Look at Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah's tafsir on that ayah as well. Second volume, 228. Look at the Fissal في الملل والأهواء والنحل by الإمام ابن الحزم رحمه الله, the third volume, page 263. مدارج السالكين by ابن القيم الجوزية رحمه الله تعالى, second volume, page 118. The كلام of ابن القيم in his كتاب الرسالة التبوكية, page 80 to page 82. And last but not least, a greater statement, very good details, ابن القيم himself in his كتاب التبيان, page 270. That's the kalam of the great imams, what they said about this particular issue. We're now going to move on to the mas'ala to thaniya, the second part, way that we want to discuss this issue. And we'll leave that inshallah ta'ala for next lesson, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. The second mas'ala that we want to talk about regarding this particular naqidh. So we've spoken about just the first mas'ala. And we've, under that first mas'ala, we brought 5 points under it. 5 points. Inshallah ta'ala, we're going to move on to the next mas'ala next week, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong, incorrect, mistakes, errors, is from me, a shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.